What is an ASCT, or autologous stem cell transplant? Why is it effective, and is it safe?
An autologous stem cell transplant, you know, we call it by several different names. One of the names is a peripheral blood stem cell transplant. Another name is a high-dose chemotherapy with stem cell support. I like the term high-dose chemotherapy with stem cell support because that's what we actually do. It's a process in which we use a very high dose of chemotherapy that we normally cannot give to a person. We use that to kill their bone marrow entirely, which basically destroys the myeloma in the person's bone marrow and also their normal cells in the bone marrow, so that if we gave it to a person without further stem cell support, their bone marrow would never function and that would be fatal. So what we actually do is collect stem cells, which are mother cells or seed cells of the bone marrow from the person, store them away in a freezer, and then give them the high dose of chemotherapy, which essentially achieves what we call myeloablation, which means destroys the bone marrow completely. So both the myeloma cells and the normal cells get destroyed. And then we use the stored frozen stem cells and infuse them back into the patient through their veins. The cells know how to go back to the bone marrow. They go there, and over a course of the next 2 weeks, they recover, and the bone marrow works normally, now hopefully rid of the myeloma cells.
Stem cell transplant is a procedure whereby we collect blood or marrow stem cells from a patient, put those in the freezer temporarily, then have the patient come in to receive high-dose chemotherapy using a drug called melphalan, and then once the melphalan is cleared from the bloodstream, we give the stem cells back to build up the blood count. So this way, patients can receive high-dose chemotherapy, which hopefully will knock down or knock out their myeloma while allowing us to rescue their bone marrow, their blood counts, from the effects of the high-dose chemotherapy using the previously collected blood or marrow stem cells.
So this has been a time-honored treatment for multiple myeloma. In fact, all the treatments that have changed the course of history in myeloma patients, this is one of the most important. Started coming in the late 1980s, and it became very, very established in the next two decades.
Why does autologous stem cell transplantation work in myeloma?
Basically, stem cell transplants work when you have a treatment that, when applied in a very high dose, kills myeloma cells proportionally more. So we have a drug called melphalan, which was probably the first ever chemotherapy that worked for myeloma well. People found that there is a dose response effect for melphalan. You give a higher dose, more cells get killed. When we get up to the higher doses, we find that melphalan destroys the normal cells in the bone marrow too much, and then the bone marrow doesn't recover back to have normal function. We need normal stem cells to rescue the person from that high dose of chemotherapy after we have given such chemotherapy.
Do the autologous stem cells have any anti-myeloma effect?
The cells that we give to the patient generally are not thought to do much. Although in some cases you could argue that they do restore immune function, and there's a little bit of an immune reboot that happens. But the vast majority of the effect in an autologous stem cell transplant or an auto transplant, which is the main transplant for myeloma, happens from the high dose of chemotherapy that we use.
Is transplant safe?
So high-dose melphalan and autologous stem cell transplantation is very safe. The likelihood of life-threatening complications is very low. Most centers would quote, you know, a value of 1% or less. A third of the patients will have grade 3 or 4 toxicities. These are non-hematologic toxicities. Almost every patient will develop pancytopenia during the process. The tolerability of high-dose melphalan has improved primarily because the supportive care that we provide to patients has improved over the last 25, 30 years.
The safety of stem cell transplant is very high nowadays as a result of the ability to collect plenty of stem cells as well as advances in supportive care. The likelihood of mortality or fatality from high-dose chemotherapy and autologous stem cell transplantation is less than 1%.